Waste management remains a major challenge for many developing countries. Several issues affect the ability of the key actors to provide sustainable service along the sanitation service chain to the different communities. The International Water Management Institute has developed a research program on circular economy and water pollution. In Ghana, in 2017, we piloted our first recycling plant, which processes fecal sludge and food waste into safe compost approved locally for marketing to farmers. Now, in 2021, we have a new facility managed through a public-private partnership model between Jekora Ventures Limited, the private entity, and the Yilo-Krobo Municipal Assembly. And this new plant is going to further contribute to food and energy security in the target area, as well as a cleaner environment. This new plant is located in Akorley, Somanya, and it combines two resource recovery solutions. First, the production of 200 metric tons of safe compost yearly. Secondly, production of 1,000 metric tons of low-cost fuel briquettes yearly. The recycling plant processes three waste streams, starting from fecal sludge from households and public toilet facilities, all collected within the Yilo-Krobo and adjoining communities. The second waste process is food waste, sourced from markets and obtained through a source separation program, which is implemented by Jekora Ventures Limited, the private entity engaged in this initiative.
Previously, we sweep much here. Now, because of waste segregation and collection, we sweep less. Now we send less waste to the dumping site, and we are happy.
The third waste stream is a mix of wood shavings, sawdust, and rice husks, all obtained from saw and rice mills, which are traditionally burned openly, leading to some air pollution. However, these waste streams are now being used to produce low-cost fuel briquettes, which is a substitute for wood and other fuel sources and is being used by households, institutions, and the industry. The fecal sludge we receive comes with organic material and nutrients, which we are interested in. But there are all sorts of different materials such as plastics, sanitary pads, condoms and clothes in it. So during this sludging, screening is done to remove these foreign materials. Then the fecal sludge flows into a sand dewatering and filtering bed for the dewatering process to start. Our dewatering unit is roofed with a transparent roofing material to facilitate operation even during rainy season and to facilitate the fecal sludge drying through the buildup of heat. The output of this step is a dried fecal sludge ready for composting. On the other hand, pre-sorted food waste from the market is further sorted to remove all foreign materials. This is then mixed with the dewatered fecal sludge for the co-composting to begin. The process takes a period of 3 months, during which the process is closely monitored. Indeed, fecal sludge contains pathogen, so the heaps are monitored to ensure average temperature of about 55 degrees Celsius are generated to kill the pathogens for safe compost production. This is very important to us to minimize the health risks. Heaps formed are turned routinely and water is added to the process. After the active phase of composting, the heaps are moved to a new chamber to cure. After composting, the bagging process begins. We produce 50 kg bags of fortified compost, which is safe for use in all forms of agricultural activity, like greenhouse farming, seedling production, and vegetable cropping.
Compost producing plant in Yilo-Krobo, which is a predominant farming community, presents a timely solution to our farmers who have used inorganic fertilizers for years. The constant use of inorganic fertilizers has affected the soil textures. It has affected the soil nutrient capacity of the soils, and this has caused rapid premature growth of their plant. All this has resulted in low crop yield of the farmers, and it has also resulted in the short shelf life of their farm produce. The department is very happy to have this plant in our district.
I'm Steven Doku, a commercial vegetable farmer. I've been farming for almost 10 years now. I use the artificial fertilizer, but it does not help the crops to grow and produce much yield. I know of the benefits of using organic manure, but it's not easy getting some around our area here. So at times I do go around looking for poultry manure. Now that I heard there is a compost plant here, I'm much happy and we are going to make use of it.
To produce briquettes, the process is rather simple. It begins with the collection of wood waste from the mills. Once on the site, depending on the moisture content, collected waste may be air-dried before it is sorted in the feeding room. It might also be crushed if the particle size exceeds our machine specifications. Then the actual production starts with the feeding of the machine. Our briquetting machine uses an environmentally friendly technology to compact the raw materials without any need for any chemical or binder additive. This results in the production of briquettes, which can easily substitute wood and other energy sources.
The Yilo-Krobo Municipal Assembly received this project with warmth and enthusiasm, and also faced with solid waste management and fecal sludge management. We are happy that these projects have been brought to the assembly. The benefit that is going to the farmers. They are going to have organic fertilizer used on their farm. Apart from that, it has also created direct and indirect jobs. The disposal sites, the quantum of refuse that goes there will reduce. The recycling plant will take part of the refuse that is sent there, particularly reference to the organic materials. I expect donors, partners and collaborators to invest in this recycling plant so that in future it can expand in such a way that we'll be able to manufacture more things and take more of the fecal sludge and the organic waste.
The International Water Management Institute is happy to support this type of circular economy business models. The experience we have gathered from the implementation of these models in different locations show that they offer great opportunities. They contribute to food security, better health, and better livelihoods for many people in the developing world.